Hello, everyone. How many people prefer I present in English? Please raise your hand.
有多少人希望我是用英文来讲？可以举手。
请问有多少位希望我用中文来讲的？
How many of you prefer me to present in Chinese? Please raise your hand.
大概多于二十个人。所以我就用中文讲。如果说你觉得翻译如果听得不太懂，那你可以举手。So
I will present this in Chinese.
好，今天我要跟大家分享的标题叫做这个新的。
It's called the new
open package.
It includes IoT, telecom, cloud, and enterprise. So it's a end-to-end edge. First, I'd like to introduce myself. I'm the enterprise architect for ARM.
Akraino Edge Stack 的 TSC 的联合主席。I'm
also the co-chair.
好，今天呢，我会介绍一下这个 LF Edge 的它是怎样形成的。First,
I will talk about the LF Edge formation, and then why Edge, what are the killer apps, how to define the Edge.
然后我会进对这个 LF Foundation Edge 进行一个总结。
And also we will summarize the LF Edge, and I have some detailed LF Edge projects. I can talk for a whole day, but today I only have 35 minutes.
So,
the Linux Foundation launched the new LF Edge to establish a unified open source framework. This year, for example, Akraino, and Eve, and Home Edge, and Glossary, which is working on the terminology, it integrates all this in the foundation edge, that is LF Edge. So they want to integrate all this. You can see the definition and their blueprint as well as use cases. And the LF Edge momentum continues. We have this Project Eve seed code and project demonstration at LOT World. Why do we need Edge and how to define the Edge? Previously, Jia Xuan from China Mobile also mentioned Edge computing. I will talk about how to solve the five challenges Jia Xuan has mentioned. You can see the emergent edge applications and convergence of technologies, and you can see different categories. For example, when it comes to NFV edge, it has autonomous device, UCP, and EPI enterprise services. They belong to telco category. And then you have autonomous device, autonomous vehicle, industry robots, and medical industry. And you have some immersive experiences, including your cloud VR, AR, 360 degree video, as well as IoT and analytics, sensors, home devices, retail, healthcare. It might require some technologies like on-demand, NFV, hardware acceleration, microservices, as well as 5G. When it comes to edge, people will ask, what are the killer apps? It might be non-traditional video plus connected things that move. You can see the top five. The first is a 360-degree video. The second is autonomous vehicle. And then AR/VR, IoT for industry purpose and gaming. You can see the source of this data. That are the areas that need edge computing. Let's look at the market opportunities for LF edge. Like industry, enterprise, consumer use cases in complex environments, and that might span multiple ages and domains. For example, industry manufacturing, Foxconn, or private LTE can do some automation by robots, and also energy, oil, gas, and utilities. That are the market opportunities for LF edge. And then people will ask, where are the edges and what is it? It's like an onion, and you can know the deeper inside. You have IoT gateway, and UCP, and then you have the smart seal, and NDC. And DC, and then you have the data center, and then you have regional DC, and then you have data center. And then below you have edge cloud, infrastructure service, local service, IoT devices. All of this belong to edge computing. Then I'd like to introduce LF Edge. I think you have heard about this. If like the operating system of LF Edge. An edge function has some industry and IoT functions and services. An Akraino Edge Stack, that's the project I'm working on. It has some enterprise IoT cases. It builds a blueprint and hardware software configuration and lifecycle management. As long as you have blueprint, then you'll use Akraino to do it. So we need to validate the blueprint to reach our purpose. Let's look at the scope of LFH. From the bottom to up, at the bottom you have the infrastructure. And then you have application interoperability. Like E for home edge. And then you have Akraino is in the raft. It spans. Akraino would provide portal to do some IoT services. And then on the top, you will do some terminology. For example, when you ask about what is edge computing, what is local service, people have different understandings. So we have this live glossary or unified terminology. For example, when you Baidu or Google edge computing, like different organizations or companies might have different definitions. But we need to make sure these definitions are unified. And then we have the
Edge X Foundry 和 Akraino 都有
like Edge X Foundry or Akraino, they need to coordinate.
好，我们看一下这个 LFH 它的 IOT 的 display。
Let's look at LF Edge current status.
像今天的话，你就可以看到它是就是几个烟囱嘛，就 AWS、Microsoft，
you have AWS、Microsoft、Baidu Cloud、Ali Cloud. Each one is like a chimney.
有了这个 Edge X or Akraino,
with Edge X Eve and Akraino,
Open API.
You can have some OP API to provide the central visibility so that they can have a unified edge stack. But that's not standardized organization, it's open source. And you don't need to write the script manually, it's automated.
那我们可以看一下这个 Edge project 我们是把 LF Edge 就是做一个大伞
We think the LF Edge is like a new umbrella for Edge projects. Like Home Edge is relatively new, focuses on home network. Akraino Edge Stack is the foundation to provide Edge stations.
好，我们来看一下。如果是说我们把 LF Edge 还有你们可能能够见到的其他的东西放到这里，怎么样
？If we put LF Edge and other key items into one graph, then how could we visualize it?
每次我讲一些高科技的东西，它就会出现那种 don't care。
So on the edge, you have mobile and residential and SMB and enterprise. And then you have home edge, Eve as operating system, and then HX Foundry together with other IoT services. And then you have heard about ONAP, Kubernetes, Akraino, that is doing AI. And then to the left, to the right, we'll have some cooperation. But mostly they are open sourced. So it spans across open access and open edge. Automating cloud, network, and IoT edge services.We cover cloud, residential services, enterprise, and IoT
edge.
So cloud and telecom network, they will do some automation. And also OpenStack. And for LF, you have ONAG, FIDO. They might provide some automation.And LF deep learning based on AI to provide automation tools. And then in infrastructure, we have cloud carrier and data center. You can see multi segments and multi use cases.Let's look at the premium members. This is open source, it's open to everyone. You can download its code, you can join. And to become a member, the only difference is that members can vote, can make some decisions, can support the decisions.You can see whether you have found your company logo. But I remember there should be 65 or 69 premium members. Linux Foundation is talking about Ali, about this premium membership. But it's free for everybody, it's open sourced. Everyone can join. It has some general members who pay a less membership fee. But it's free to all of you, actually. So let's summarize. There are three takeaways of LFH. First is harmonizing open source edge communities across IoT, enterprise, cloud, and telecom. It will also help LFH to be open and interoperable. Involve hardware, silicon, cloud, OS, protocol vendors. So involve the upstream, downstream stakeholders of the whole industry. It put the clients into the same blueprint and to solve the latency and other issues. It's hosted by Linux Foundation. It's also very similar to CNCF.
Okay, so now let's give you a true introduction to the projects. So first one is Akraino Edge Stack. Yeah, I believe I didn't mention this picture. This is a use case number one, operators own network edge. As you can see, from the latency perspective, the left side latencies are quite long. And then from the host perspective and also the operator's perspective, so it's about 5 milliseconds. And also for cellular, it's about 1 to 3 milliseconds. And then it's 5 to 20 milliseconds. So the number of nodes range from small to large, and the time range from 5 to 15 milliseconds for the section on the right. So many applications need to less than 20 milliseconds. So this is an IoT use case. You can see these logos above, Akraino Edge Stack. So cloud automation. And these scenarios are integrated into one. So what's the mission of Akraino? So first, we want to integrate the blueprints. Focus on upstream first. So if your company raised a blueprint, then you need to first go to another department. Then we need to follow certain steps to write the code and to contribute. We have several projects going on.
NFV, AR, VR,
and AR. using APIs. So to provide an integrated API for all of these, and we encourage the vendors to validate their issues. So each blueprint has a user. You don't have to tell us when you will be deployed, but you need to give us validation. Such as scientific projects are excluded from this scenario. It's a very user-oriented.
We released release one. It was released on May 31st.
But on June the 6th, we had the official news. We released about 10 groupings. So we delivered. Okay, it works.
So just unifying the edge.
So it was mainly for unifying the edge. It provided several tested, validated, deployment ready.
Deployment ready blueprints.
So think about why AT&T team members come to help us, because they thought that these meet their expectations and they want to make a big investment to make it real. So here there are three P's I want you to remember:
projects,
profits, and
products.
And they are pushing these products, and when we sell these products to our clients, we'll get profits. So this is like a cycle. Here, let's see why it is called a blueprint.
So there are about four
sections here. Most importantly, there's a CI/CD integrated testing. So from upstream community, you can get it all, but for lower stream community, it is harder. So from edge to edge core, there are five levels. So you might ask, what's the difference between blueprint 1 and blueprint N? For example, the blueprint 1 include all the same types of vehicles, and the other blueprint N might include another types of all the cars. And now we have some tested and validated deployment ready blueprints. I think I have known some technical lead from PTL. Congratulations. The first one is called Network Cloud. It's a unicycle with SRIOV and OBS DPDK. Unicycle. So, there are about 6 to 7 servers controlling the nodes, about 5 data nodes. So the primary user case are closely related to 5G. And telco appliances is a radio edge cloud. it's a control on the rake. So why is it called toggle appliances? It's guided by AT&T. So when in the future they want to do a large scale deployment, they want to integrate a whole set of software and hardware and to deploy according to this standard. For example, if they want to build some dark images, they can integrate these all together and make it large scale. And for IEC, several companies were closely involved. So the release one partnership was for type 1 and type 2, small edge and medium edge. It can be run on edge server, providing some good versions.
Starling X,
the Far Edge Distributed Cloud.
Starling X and the Far Edge Distributed Cloud.
Kubernetes. Has two groupings, provider access edge and the enterprise edge.
Edge lightweight and IoT blueprint
includes IoT gateway and UCP. Is there anyone from Akraino PTL? They might come for the next session. So to summarize, the network cloud family is in this picture. As I mentioned, Unicycle, it's a rack including all of the servers, so the blue parts are from upstream, and the green stream provided by Akraino R1. Unicycle and Rover. This is mainly worked for 5G.
Okay. Unicycle OVS-DPDK,
is similar to the previous picture. But the scenario is let's check out this radio edge cloud. This is a telco appliance concept use cases. These are very small and edge side devices integrating OREC and RIC customized tailored apps with zero touch. We can establish automated CD pipeline testing the full software stack. And another one, the Far Edge Cloud, using the API from Edge Foundry, integrating the Starling Edge.
IEC
Just as I mentioned, the Kubernetes are very concise and small. The feedback can also be run on type 2. So you can deploy them, which are run on by a connected vehicle, and including gaming and other AI video analytics. So many people are interested in the
AIOT.
So Huawei Public Cloud can use it directly. If you're interested, have a try, and it provides. Many clients with the portal. Next one is R1 blueprint.
And it heavily depends on Kubernetes. If you put in Edge, it solves two problems. One is Keras Edge, the other is Industry Edge. So in the dotted frame, you can see the Kubeflow and Kubeverk, how it could be applied and integrated. This is a demo graph, it's not a copy. It can be used in some gateway. For radio edge, you can deploy it at rack, or you can deploy it at mini data center. Or in the premise DCH, or Taco Edge. So it has different layers, one layer after another. So to summarize, key takeaways, Elf Edge projects has gained some community support. Here, I also want to thank the developers and contributors. And the biggest feature is the deployment ready. It provides a unified framework for edge collaboration. R1 has released 10 plus blueprints for IoT enterprise and telco edge cloud. And for the new blueprints, they are on the track. It might involve gaming, connected vehicles. We already have the existing blueprint. We're going to release the next version in November. And we'll also have some tool development and also like tools for automated blueprint validation. And the new community lab is just established. You can also work with our lab to do your own blueprint. Because of limited time, I will not elaborate on other projects. Do you have any questions? Okay. If there are no other questions, I will not talk about the HX foundry. I have uploaded the materials and PowerPoints. Okay, thank you.